well within time or relative?
Good morning, everybody. For those of you who doesn't know me, my name is Abhrudeep Bhattacharya. I'm part of the SDSI team. And I'm going to introduce to you a new concept. So, in the year 1964, Doc Edgerton inspired us with awe and curiosity with this picture of a bullet traveling through an apple, an exposure of a millionth of a second. 50 years down the line, we can go a million times faster. We can create videos, not a million or a billion, but a trillion frames per second. I'm going to introduce to you this topic called femtophotography. Femtophotography is a new imaging technique. This imaging technique is so advanced that it can create videos of light in slow motion. So, what does this bring to the table, you say? Most of you may ask about this. Femtophotography will allow us to look around corners, to look beyond line of sight, or even inside the human body without the use of an X-ray. And it will really challenge what we mean when we say, what is a camera? So, if I take a laser pointer and I turn it on and off a trillion times a second, I'll get a packet of photons that is exactly a millimeter wide. This packet of photons, when I suppose, say, as you saw that bullet going through the apple, right? Suppose if I pass this packet of photons inside a bottle, what will happen, right? How will the photons scatter? How will light travel through the bottle? So this is the packet of photons entering the bottle. As you can see, light is being scattered and the packet of photons is becoming very small. Now when it hits the cap, light reflects back. You can see some of the lights lingering over the top of the air bubble. And after some time, when it comes to the back of the bottle, you'll see a reflection forming over here. So this is how a packet of photon is exactly scattering. And through femtophotography, you can see how this is passing through the bottle. So, using this, how, you may ask, so how does this help in seeing around corners or beyond line of sight? So this diagram will actually explain to you. Say we pass a packet of photons onto the door. This packet of photons will get reflected inside the room, obviously, as you know. Now, some of those photons will actually come back, hit the door and come back to the camera. Through this, we can create the image of what is inside the room. Now, you guys must say that this is all too science fiction and it's all just a concept. But no, this thing really exists and it has already been created. So, when the paper was first published, Nature Communications actually created an experiment that will show how this is done. As you can see, we have our femtocam over here. We have this wall. There's a hidden mannequin in behind the wall, which the cam doesn't see yet. And there is the dome. So how does this work? Nature Communications actually created a video that shows how this imaging technique may help us. So one laser pulse is fired. Now this laser pulse, or a packet of photons as I've said, will hit this wall, and since it's a packet of photon, it will scatter. This packet of photons again will hit the mannequin. It will scatter again, it will hit the wall, and then it's going to come back. Some of those photons are going to come back to the camera. The most important thing is, these packet of photons will reach at different times. So, how do we manage to get it all together, right? You may ask. This camera is not an ordinary camera. It's a femtocam with a time resolution of 2 picoseconds. That is exactly the time taken for light to travel 0.6 kilometers. millimeters, sorry. So now we know how the how light travels, right? With the when the pulse is fired. So when this comes back, an image you see, it's calculating the distance, and the image is created on the wall. Now, if we take a million such images, we can get the picture of what is behind the wall. So after gathering all the images and running some very complicated algorithms, this is the image that we get. So as you can see, it's not a very clear image, but you can see that there is something behind the wall and its posture. So now, with this fender photography, what we can do, in real life situations, cars may see around the corners and may avoid collisions before actually turning. Firefighters may find out where the bodies are inside a burning house before actually entering into the house. And in cardioscopes, using this, we can find out where the blockage is before even cutting open the body. So actually, this concept is open sourced. It's all there in the website, and it's really a call for researchers and creative people to come and show people to stop obsessing about megapixels and get into the mood of accepting the new dimension. It's all about time, and thank you.
But we need a lot of image processing and huge processing.
See, it's very simple. 50 years down the time, no one thought that there will be cameras of 8 megapixels fitted inside one mobile, right? So this is a concept that is out there. The design is open source. Many researching community can come and develop on this. It's not a hidden hush-hush. And it's all done by MIT University.
Is there anywhere it's implemented already?
No, it's still in the researching community, and actually the femtocam, that it took around $100,000 just to build the lens for it. So it's basically still on ongoing research.
So do you think it's a high investment is required for putting it in work?
See, 2 years down the line, the maximum amount of picture that was taken was 50 megapixel, right? 2 years now, it's 50 gigapixel. Size, everything is becoming small. So 10 years down the line, we may have this.
No, but one more thing is, when you see the image develop, I think it takes more size, it takes more processing.
Obviously, with the technology that we have now, actually it will take around 50 GBs of data to create that one small image.
Have you heard a technology about which can penetrate through walls and get the image? What about that? That also can be implemented, right? Why we have to do this kind of
This is around going around the corners, right? That's what I'm saying.
Which requires implementing complex algorithms and more technology, more power, and more money as what you mentioned.
So going through walls, was it much cheaper?
No, I'm telling you, why can't they implement that one so that it will be direct at least?
Obviously. There are a lot of concepts out there. I'm just presenting this concept and how this may help us in real life solutions.
Okay, one more thing. Is it going to harm anywhere the human hazards? Are there something like that?
No.
No, right?
It's all light, right? A set of photons coming from a team.
James could have
hunted long back. Any more questions?
No. Thank you.